No disclaimers on this feed. Well, that's because I won't be talking about an uncomfortable subject today. No, today I'll be doing a film theory-like video. Have you seen the 1996 horror movie The Dentist? Well, I haven't. But this video will be talking about the death from that film. But Federation Blue, sir, I hear you commenting. How can you be talking about a movie you haven't seen yet? You say. Well, to answer you, I just have to reveal one of my major character traits. I just love reading Wikipedia articles. Back in high school, I'd read the plot of movies in Wikipedia because they were so over-explained and I couldn't afford to buy any movie tickets, and I hadn't learned any nice pirating websites so that I could pirate those movies nicely and say that I actually watched that movie. That is what I have done to the movie The Dentist, which I also presume would be a very horrible movie because I just saw its trailers on YouTube and it sucks. Okay then, back to the death or kill scene. Okay, so Alan, the killer dentist, kills this woman, I presume, whose name is Karen, by injecting her with a syringe filled with air in her jugular vein. A very creative kill, I assume, because I don't watch a lot of horror movies, and the only horror I consume is in the form of Ito Junji's manga and H.P. Lovecraft's very racist novels. Alright, fine, I'm a weeb and a bookworm, okay? Anyway, what the movie shows us is a scaled-up version of why doctors do that anxiety-inducing act of tapping the injection a couple of times and squeeze out a bit of liquid. And the reason isn't because they're sadists, who know that you know that that needle will hurt because you are an trypanophobic child. No, it's because of their knowledge in medicine. Well, you see, the circulatory system is a very strict system because it only requires substances in the liquid state flowing within it. If something solid or gaseous starts flowing within the system, it will cause problems, hemodynamic problems, such as a complete stoppage of blood flow or turbulent flow of blood in vessels. The medical term for this non-liquid substance is an embolism. Embolisms are very dangerous because they can impede blood flow, and I don't think they can be removed. Oh, wait a sec, let me just fact check that. Okay, that's interesting. Okay then, there you have it. They can dissolve on their own, and yeah, I made a mistake. But yeah, I kind of deserve the pass because remember, I'm still a freshman, okay? But in The Dentist, let's say that the syringe is halfway full because I didn't watch the movie, and I mean, Mad Pet's theories are cooler when they have some assumptions, right? Am I the only one who thinks that really? This could create a large embolism, one that could potentially completely block the jugular vein and could either increase the blood pressure high enough to pop an artery in the brain, and you don't want that in the brain, or depriving the heart of enough red blood cells and thus it getting insufficient oxygen and the heart getting a myocardial infarction, a smart way of saying heart attack. And this gives us two ways to have minus one carrying in this world. Okay, now I feel like I am smart because not only did I show understanding in this video, I also applied my knowledge on embolisms and hemodynamic disorders, which is an achievement seeing that I'm a freshman. Well, it seems as if my channel is growing, and I see that I now have 3 subscribers and my views on my previous videos are reaching the double digits. I honestly didn't expect so many people to be watching my bad videos. So this is probably my last video which I shall be posting in such rapid succession, because spring break is about to end and I have been procrastinating to study. I just hope that my grandmother doesn't hear about this, because she'd kill me if she does. And as always, thanks for watching.